All right, guys, I'm gonna do a review of my Li-Ning N90 III. So, my previous badminton racket review, I did a review of my Li-Ning N99, which I have since sold. I didn't feel that racket was quite for me. This is actually my go-to racket. I use a towel wrap for the grip. And I've been using this racket now. I just prefer this racket over the N99. So the N93 is sort of the spiritual successor of the N90 Woods, that Lin Dan racket. And having used the Lin Dan racket, the N90 Woods, the original, I can definitely see where Li-Ning has drawn that feel from. It is a little bit different, and I'm going to explain that later on in the video. First, I'm just going to go over the design of this racket. I personally think it's quite unique. I think the detailing is quite nice. So, I mean, like they have the silver here that's chrome, and then they have these lines, and they just have a nice design. It seems like they really put the effort. And then the red sort of sparkly accents are quite nice, and so it reads 3D break free N93, and then on the side here it says TB Nano stabilized torsion angle. You'll notice with Li-Ning rackets is they have a lot of sort of scripture on their rackets. This is bio inner cone, and then moving up you have this where the shaft meets the head, it's black. And that's a really big standout feature in this racket. And then moving on to the head, you can see again more red accents here. Again, it's got that chrome shininess going there. Lots of lines and design work, the TB Nano script up there. And up here at the tip of the head, it's all scratched up. This is more text. I think it says reinforcing technology, and then on the side of the head says wing stabilizer. And yeah, Li-Ning just they really like their text. And on the other side it says dynamic optimum frame. So all these things. Oh, one more we got here. What does that say? That says, let's see if we can make that out. Dynamic, no. That says Aerotech Beam System. And all these things are gonna make you a world champion. Guaranteed. No, I'm just joking. So, design-wise, I think it's quite nice. This sort of has this feathery look in the gray, mixed with these chrome red accents all around the racket. And then this black center, the center where the shaft meets the head is black, and that is the biggest standout. You know, if you have this racket and you go to your club and you're looking around, looking at someone swinging, you'll know they are holding this racket based on this, the blackened head where meeting the shaft area, because the rest of the racket's quite bright. It's white and silver and red. And then suddenly it's just pitch black where the head meets the shaft. Every time I see someone else use this racket at the club, I know immediately it's my racket because of this design element here. Who uses this racket? So the notable players on the national Chinese team that use this racket is Sun Yu. Sun Yu uses this racket exclusively. I've never seen her use any other racket in her tournaments. And the other notable player that has now retired from the national team that uses this racket, I don't know if he still uses it now in his club play, but when he was on the national team, the other player that used this racket was Wang Jingming. So he was the youth champion at one point and never really exploded into the professional level. But he is also a player that uses racket. And I think there's one more current national player that uses this racket as well. But so for professionals, that's who uses this racket. So this racket is it's a Li-Ning calls it. It's a flexible. It's a medium flex. This is the because it's an N series. It is their top of the line series. It's a military carbon fiber grade one piece racket. And what that means is that you can really string these rackets to very high tension. So most club players or most players in general will probably string between 23 and 26, 27. But you can string these over 30 if you want. On the website it says I think the horizontal max is 30 and the vertical is 28. But first-hand experience when I was in China and I spoke to a certified Li-Ning provincial level stringer. In China, you as a stringer, you need to be certified. You have to have a certificate to string for teams. So she said that, honestly, pros string their rackets very, very high tension. So that's sort of the insider information there. I have mine strung to 30. I play 30 pounds on all my rackets. Even when I buy a new racket, I'm trying it out. I'll string it to 30. I'm going to go in a little bit about racket string tension. So I use Li-Ning number one strings. I have tried Yonex BG series strings, but I just prefer the number one string now. I think I'm just accustomed to it. I don't think it's better or worse. I think I'm just used to the way it feels. It's quite durable and they have good feel and they don't even sound too bad. So that's why I like the string. And they're much cheaper than Yonex strings, so even when they do break, it's not that big of a deal for me. When you string a racket to 30, you want to make sure that. So the difference, a lot of people wonder what is it, why do people string so high? Or why do people string so low? Why are these players that I've been playing with for a long time, or they're very good and high skill, and they think string high is really stupid and redundant. So, while professionals are stringing, the top players in the world string high over 30 pounds, there's obviously a clear reason. Now, there are advantages in string high, obviously, otherwise, the top players in the world would be stringing the rackets at 20 pounds and not 32, 35 pounds. However, when you string a racket in a high tension, you have to hit in the sweet spot, because if you don't hit in the sweet spot, there's basically two things that will happen. If the racket wasn't strung properly, your strings will break. And that's already not the worst thing. The worst thing is if your technique is not good enough, if you're not hitting the birdie in the sweet spot of the racket, then you have no power. Your shots are not accurate. Your shots are sort of inconsistent. So if your technique isn't right, your footing isn't right, you don't have the exact positioning when you're swinging at the bird, and your racket is strung high, you'll notice that your smashes are really slow. Your drops fall really short. And your slices are, they might actually pop up high, and your net shots might not even go over the net a lot of times because you're just not you're not hitting you're not slicing the bird on the right spot of the racket. So there's a huge advantage. If you do get your technique right, your footing is correct, you're in the right position when you're smashing, etc. A high tension is really good because those smashes are going to go down really fast. Your drops drop very, very quickly as well. And your net shots, honestly, I actually feel net shots, even if you're not perfectly in position all the time, with a high tension, you have a lot more feel because it's so stiff. You can really, really direct the bird on the net shots. The only thing that makes it quite difficult is when you're out of position, you're really, really stretching and leaning, and you want to do a cross-court net shot with your wrist, and the bird's already maybe about only 2 feet away or a foot away from the ground. So you're doing almost like a trick shot, going across all the way to the other end with a stiff string. You need to, again, it's all about positioning. If you hit the bird here, the bird's not going to get over the net. If you hit the bird here, it might also just not get over. Or if you just put a little bit too strength, or you give it too much height, and the person will just smash it down at you at the net, if that person is an attentive net player as well. So when you get a racket, I always feel that if you're going to spend the money on a top of the end racket like the N series from Li-Ning, you should learn to use the racket to its ability. So, string it to 27, string it to 28, string it to, start. Just try to improve your game by stringing your racket higher, because you'll notice when you string a racket higher, it does not hide your mistakes. When you have a tension that's low, at 22, 23, it really hides your mistakes. You can smash the birdie here, and it still have decent speed. You can smash it here or here and all that stuff. And it hides your technique, basically. So that's why lower tensions are better for beginners and intermediate players, because it makes you not make as many mistakes. You can still play at a very high level game without making mistakes. And once you go high in tension, then you really, really need to be on top of the bird, so to speak. So that was a lot about racket string tension. How does this racket feel? It's definitely not nearly as stiff as, say, the Z-Force line of Yonex. And it's definitely not as stiff as the N99. This is a lot more flexible, and I like that flex. It's more like a whip for a racket. It is not that head heavy. It's more center, and the weight balance is definitely directed more down the shaft. Having said that, it's definitely not headlight, so some really dedicated front court players, say mixed doubles or something like that, there are some rackets designed that are very, very headlight. I played with some very headlight rackets, and they have unreal type of response, so it's just so easy to get behind the bird on playing defense. But I think this racket, why I like this racket so much, is because I think it's a great all-around racket. It's just head-heavy enough to provide excellent smashing and dropping control, but it's also not so stiff that it makes the hot racket very bad in defense. So in my opinion, the stiffness of a racket plays a big role in how the racket feels. So this racket is supposed to weigh identical to the N99, but because this racket is more flexible and the balance is further back, then it feels much lighter. Whereas if you can have the same weight racket but have a much stiffer shaft, the racket automatically feels heavier, even though it's not heavier, but it feels heavier. And if it feels heavier, then basically your defense and response times are going to be worse off. And because a stiffer racket will always have worse defense, then as a doubles, I play doubles, then this is going to suit me better. Most of the singles players out there, the best singles players out there in singles dedicated rackets, have really stiff shafts, like the Z-Force, for example. Li Tongwei's rackets, and even Chen Long's racket, the N55, which I used to have, is very stiff, much stiffer than this. And they do that because in singles, your defense isn't as important as doubles, because the bird doesn't come back to you as quickly in singles than it does in doubles. So the pace is a lot slower in singles. So that's why those rackets are designed that way. Having said that, this makes an excellent singles racket, like Sun Yu, Wang Zhengming. They all use this. They use this racket in their singles player. So this is actually designed as a singles racket, but I think the rackets have sort of evolved into being for singles being really stiff. So this has sort of evolved into a really great doubles racket as well. If you're mixed doubles, this you and you're male, this would be absolutely excellent backcourt racket. But at the same time, if you just increase your strength a little bit, this also is definitely flexible and light enough to be a front court. I'm more of a front court player, but at the same time, when I'm at the back, it's definitely not a disadvantage to my partner. And I consider myself a better front court player than a back court player, but sometimes, if I'm at the back and I need to put a couple smashes down, and this racket does not fail me at all. I don't ever feel it's too heavy for the front, and I never feel that it's too light to get some good smashes down. So I really like this racket. Overall, this is a really sturdy racket too. I mean, this thing is banged up and chipped, and I've swung full speed at my partner's before his racket, and no cracks in. No cracks, lots of paint chipping, but no cracks. So I'm really, really impressed with this racket. I do want to pick up another racket. I sold my N99. I just didn't get used to it. I want to pick up the N90 Woods, basically the original N90 series racket, because I did try that out and I was in love with how that felt. It felt like a slightly heavier version of this racket, but almost slightly heavier yet also slightly more flexible. So it was a very, very interesting combination. And I sort of like that, and I want to try that out. But if I bought that racket, I don't think I would sell this one. And even if I like that one more, I don't think I would sell this one, because this is such a good all-around racket. Like, what can I say? The N93 is a really good all-rounder. So if you're a doubles player or even a singles player, and you're looking at a high-end racket, that actually won't break the bank because this model has been out for a while now. I think these can go for well under $180, $170 Canadian, and you can probably get strings with them as well. This is definitely something you want to look into, at least give it a shot, because the weight balance, the flexibility, the ability to handle high tension strings, and the durability as well. It's really, really good. Good racket. So that is the N93. That's my review. I would again I consider myself, in my last video I said I consider myself like an advanced intermediate. I recently, last Monday, played with an advanced group, and I would say I'm right there with them. So I'm still going to call myself an advanced intermediate, though. I don't consider myself fully advanced yet. I don't think I have that consistency. And my backhand is pretty abysmal. But I think an intermediate player can work its way into this racket. If you're intermediate, don't be afraid to purchase this racket. You can always work up to it, get used to the balance, get used to the weight. String a racket maybe 24 in the beginning, work your way up. When I first started stringing my rackets high tension, it felt uncomfortable. But you have to work with that. You have to get out of your comfort zone. You gotta improve your swing speed. You gotta improve your footwork to match what the pros are doing, because that's the only way you're gonna improve. And having said that, even for me, I don't like stiff rackets, but a coach once told me, just on the sidelines, he wasn't coaching me, but just on the sidelines, he's saying, rackets like the N99, he saw me using, and like the new Z Forces, they're so stiff now. And they feel so heavy that they require a totally new type of technique to play. And if you're unwilling to readjust yourself to play with that amount of stiffness in a racket, then don't buy the racket. Don't try to play with it, because it's just, you need to relearn to sort of play it with those rackets. And it basically is the same thing for string tension, except I think string tension is something everyone should sort of strive for, because string tension, ultimately, if you have a higher tension and you're hitting the bird on the sweet spot, you'll get a lot more power, a lot more speed, your clears will be easier, will go farther, and overall with a tighter string means there's more consistency in your feel. So that's the N90 III. I highly recommend this racket. It's quite contrary to what I said about the N99. The N93, I think the design is pretty unique. I don't actually think it's a good looking racket, but I think it's a unique design, and it's very durable, and it's just a great all-rounder. So yeah, hope you like this review, and I'll probably be doing some more badminton racket reviews in the future. So like this video if you found this helpful, subscribe, and I'm hoping to take some footage of me playing as well in the future. So hopefully that will give you more of an idea of how these rackets perform in a practical setting. Thanks for watching.